The Nigeria Police Force,
Oyo State Police Command, on Thursday paraded some suspects arrested for various criminal offenses, including armed robbery, kidnapping, and fraud at the police state headquarters, Eleile, Ibadan. The State Commissioner of Police, CP Joe Nwachukwu Enwonwu, states that the unrelenting effort by the police tactical teams led to their arrest, as some exhibits, including cash amounting to 550,800 naira, recovered from them. The CP calls on the general public to take extra precautions during the Ember month in order to avoid falling into the hands of nefarious criminals who are desperate for ill-gotten wealth, while also assuring them of the force effort to keep them safe this period.
We are making all the necessary efforts within this Ember month to be sure that people will sleep with their two eyes closed. And we will not rest on our oars to be sure that anybody involved in any criminal activity will be made to face the full wrath of the law. While we are doing that, we will still observe the rules of our engagement, which is to respect the fundamental human rights of such suspected persons.
He implores the public to go about their lawful businesses while partnering with the police to fish out criminal elements, urging them to always call the police emergency numbers in times of distress.
I implore all the good citizens of Oyo State to go about their lawful businesses without any fear of molestation from any quarters, while they are to always make use of the two emergency control room numbers in case of any distress situation, viz. 070-5549-5413 and 080-817-6814. The people are also enjoined to continue to partner with the police, collaborate, and support us with very useful and timely, credible information to enable us to serve the community better.
The items recovered include guns, life cartridges, cell phones, huge amount of money, ATM cards, exotic cars, and others. Some of the criminal paraded, which include armed robbers, kidnappers, fraudsters, while speaking with some news correspondents, have this to say.
So we are dealing with a group of people.
Okay.
So we are giving them a loan. So maybe starting from 100, 150 and 200. So that is how we are doing it.
What propelled you, what pushed you to go into this crime? Is it unemployment or you just have flair for filthing people, fleecing people?
I've worked with one, is it, I don't know their name, is it, they call them Richards or something like that.
Okay.
So they fraud them. So I was the marketer then. I'm the marketer when I was working with them. So yeah, which I don't
what
know.
What brought you here?
Which I don't know that they are frauders. So after that, they run away. So they catch me up that I'm the part of them and I don't know anything. So that's when that's the place that I gained the orientation to do the.
To also continue.
Yes.
My mission was that I'm going to take the baby along with me to the Lara Monkey.
Do what?
To train her as my own child.
Tell us the truth.
I'm telling you the truth.
What did you intend to do with the baby? Tell us the truth.
The
game is over now, you know.
I don't intend to do anything with him, just to brought him up as my.
Are you married?
I'm married, but we dispatched on April.
You and your husband?
Yes.
Do you have any kids for you?
I'm pregnant by then.
Then what happened to the pregnancy?
The pregnancy spoiled.
Concerning the case of rape and defilement, the commissioner said.
I know a lot of you will be interested in the issue of rape and defilement. I want to confirm to you that all the arrests made so far on rape and defilement have been charged to court, and many of them have been remanded. But yet, people are not learning their lessons. We are still getting reports of some people who newly got themselves involved in rapes and defilement, but they have not been transferred to the state CIID. They are doing the preliminary investigations, and as soon as they are done with that, they'll transfer to the state CIID.
Speaking on the directives of the Inspector General of Police concerning NSAS, he said,
I tell you that before this directive came, that tall order has been read over and over, and we have made sure that we do thorough supervision of the SAS and all the tactical teams to ensure compliance. So we don't have any complaint as we speak. In the last 4 months I've been CP here, against either SAS or any of the tactical teams. We have always warned them to be very professional in their approach to their duties and to respect the fundamental human rights. Now, in addition to all this, concerning what the IG has just said and the position of the federal government, we have further warned them to stay off patrols. We have, in addition, warned them not to do roadblocks. We have also told them to always be on their gear, operational gear, anytime they want to walk. In other words, we have returned them back to their offices to face the investigations they are doing, but that does not at the same time stop them from responding to distress calls. Once distress calls are made, they will rush and respond to save the citizens from being killed or from being attacked, and so on and so forth. Furthermore, that does also not stop them from raiding criminal hideouts and black spots. Their own is to do thorough surveillance, get sufficient information on the area to be raided, and they will do that.